Alright guys, today we're going to do a quick video demonstration of the new remote system from Oracle Lighting. Real briefly, we just want to familiarize you guys with the new remote because there are some changes that we made. On the previous model remote seen here, the key fob was made out of plastic, so if you were to drop this, step on it, roll over it, it would break obviously pretty easily. The new remote actually has a stainless steel chassis on it, so it's a lot more rugged than the previous version. And as an added little safety feature, it's got this cover that can slide up and protect the keys. This is so when you've got your keys in your pocket, you don't actually press one of these keys or one of these buttons on the actual remote and turn things on or off when you're not intended to do so. So that's a neat little feature there. The second thing you'll notice is the box itself. The box is a lot smaller than the previous version box. This is, you know, a fraction of the size. And for some people it wasn't too important, but for guys with motorcycles or with vehicles where there's not a lot of room to install, shrinking it down as much as possible was important. The next thing when you look at the box you'll notice is that all the wiring is pre-installed. On the older model you actually had a connector here and you would attach wires to here and plug it in. We basically just did away with some of that to simplify things. Right here you've got your main power wire. It's fused for you so you don't have to go add your own fuse. You have black wire, obviously, is a ground. This would go down clean chassis ground. The wires here and here are your output wires. This would go to the actual devices that you were powering up. And there's another wire, if you look right here. This is a little hard to see, but this is the antenna wire. And well, the other box didn't have an antenna wire. That's because on the other box, the antenna was actually on the remote. So, you know, some people felt that was a little bit old school, so we did away with the antenna on the remote and put the antenna on the box. The other cool feature that we have here is that the remote and the box are paired in frequency. We had some issues where if you had a remote box from us and your neighbor had a remote box from us, you could accidentally turn on and off your neighbor's lights if you were in close enough proximity. So everything's frequency matched. You don't have to keep these stickers on, but you do want to make a note of your frequency on your controller so that if you were ever to lose your controller, we could replace it with one that would match the frequency of your controller. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the actual functionality and how this works. All right, we're gonna go through the remote functions real quick. We've got a set of headlights here with halos in them. We're basically gonna show you the two different channels. Not that you're gonna wanna put two different headlights on two different channels. This is strictly for demonstration purposes to show the differences when we're using two different channels with two different functions. All right, I'm gonna start by taking the, let's look at D. D's still going to do the same thing as the other remote, where D's going to control the on-off functionality. Next, we're going to take A. We're going to press and hold A. And what that's going to do is that's going to activate the dimmer. This dimmer actually has 100 steps between dim and bright, rather than 6 steps like the old controller. It looks a little bit funny on camera. It's fluttering a little bit, but in person, this is a pretty smooth transition. And once we find a setting that we're happy with, we release it. Let's go ahead and turn these all the way back up. So that's A, and basically I could also take A, and if I wanted to turn off one of the channels, I could not press and hold, but just press A, and that would turn off, in this case, turn off what we have our left headlight set on. We'll call it channel A, and then press it again, it'll turn off channel B and turn on channel A, and then press it a third time, it'll turn on both channels. So we're gonna go over to B, and B is, going to be our strobe channel in this case. So here we get an alternating strobing pattern. That's just by doing a quick press on B. So if we were to press B again, we would be getting a little bit different wig-wag type pattern here. And then in this case, we press B again, and just the right headlight is going to strobe. We press it again, and just the left headlight is going to strobe. And then pressing it again, we'll just have both strobing similar to the function of the older remote. thing would be C, and the C is going to be getting into our auto dimmer functions here. So I'm going to press C one time, and it's going to have just channel A, what we're calling channel A, in this case, dimming on and off. We call this an auto dimmer, breathing. This is just the function where it's basically ramping up voltage and then bringing down the voltage. So we're going to go ahead and press that button again, and now we have both sides simultaneously doing this breathing function. I'm going to press it one more time. It's just going to go over to the right side here. Again, it's just doing the breathing function. And we'll press it a third time, and what we have is the right channel is doing a breathing function, and the left channel is doing a strobing function. So this would be good if you have a dual color halo kit and you want one color to slowly get brighter and dimmer on its own, the other color to strobe. That would be a neat feature to have. In this case, it just looks kind of weird because we've got two different headlights doing two different things. The D button is the last button here, and that's just basically going to turn everything off and then turn it back on. As you can see, this has memory to it, so whatever setting it was on when we turn it off is going to be the same setting when we go back and turn it back on.